Assalamu alaikum. Topic Unit 3, which is Poem Dreams, Book Exercise, Class 10, Subject English. Today we will complete our book exercise. Your first question in your book exercise is, write the correct option in the following statement. The phrase hold fast to dreams means, what is the meaning of hold fast to dreams? So hold fast to dreams means stick fast to your ambition in life. Stick fast, मजबूती से थामो, your ambition in life, अपने aims of life. Ambition in life, aims of life. In the line, life is a broken winged bird, the poet uses the technique of dash. Metaphor, personification, simile, repetition. So life is a broken winged bird. It is a direct association of one thing with other. Life is directly associated with broken winged bird, so it is definitely metaphor. Life is a barren field. In this line, the phrase a barren field is dash. A barren field. It is also directly associated with, life is directly associated with barren field, so it is also metaphor. According to the poet, life without dream is dash. Life without dream is hollow and bleak, lush and hopeful, dynamic and productive, passionate and optimistic. Life without dreams is hollow and bleak, empty and gloomy. According to dreams, what will happen if our dreams die? Life will be easier to handle, life will be appear as it is, life will continue as normal, life will be hopeless. According to dreams, what will happen if our dream dies? Life will be hopeless. Zindagi na umeed ho jayegi. Now coming to transitive and intransitive verb. So what is transitive and intransitive? We have learned it in our previous topics, but I'll explain it, transitive and intransitive, for you for one more time. What is transitive? In shortly, you can say a transitive verb which takes its object and which answers the question what and whom. And what is intransitive? Intransitive, it gives a complete sense in itself and it is used without object. So do as directed. Choose a sentence that does not have an intransitive verb. So what this statement means? The statement means choose a sentence that does not have an intransitive verb. It means that we have to find the transitive. Choose the sentence that does not have an intransitive verb. It means that we have to, most of these have intransitive, but you have to figure out which one is transitive. So I jog, it is intransitive. The child gurgles, it is intransitive. She sobs, it is intransitive. So I watched a movie. We have to find transitive verb. What the question says, choose the sentence, wo jumla muntakhib kare that does not have intransitive verb, jisme intransitive verb na ho. So this is the sentence which does not have intransitive verb because it is transitive verb. Understand? I watched a movie. I, subject, watched, verb, a movie, object. So if I make a question, watched what, it is giving me the answer, a movie. So it is transitive verb. You have to pick this sentence. It is the correct answer. Choose the sentence that does not have a transitive verb. It means most of these are comprised of transitive verb. We have to figure out intransitive verb. He presented a bouquet, it is transitive. She waved his arm, transitive. She understood my question, transitive. She laughed heartily. She laughed heartily, wo dil se muskurai. It is intransitive verb. So you have to pick this one. Choose the sentence that does not have a transitive verb. Means most of these will be transitive and we have to find out intransitive. We showed her the flower vase. The grocer is selling vegetables. The birds are flying. The birds are flying. This is intransitive. We do not know the birds are flying. It is without an object. So it is intransitive. Choose a sentence that does not have an intransitive verb. So most of these will be intransitive and we have to figure out transitive. The customer is buying this afternoon. The customer is buying pancakes. So the customer is buying what? Pancakes. It is intransitive. This is the correct answer. Choose a sentence that does not have a transitive verb. So does not, जिसमें transitive verb ना हो, मतलब कि हमें intransitive verb ढूंढना है. Asma shouted in the class. It is intransitive verb. Choose the sentence that does not have an intransitive verb. The students is answering question. We have to find out transitive. The student is asking what? Questions. The student is asking questions. So this is intransitive. This is transitive. And rest of the three is intransitive. Now coming to present participle or past participle. What is present participle and past participle? Have a look on this chart. We have verbs, some words of verb, and then we have simple past. Now the past participle. What is past participle? Past participle is the form of verb ending in ed. The past participle is the form of verb ending in ed, which is used in forming perfect and passive tense. It is used in forming perfect and passive tense. It is all about past participle. Now coming to present participle. What is present participle? The form of verb ending in ing. The form of verb ending in ing, which is used in forming continuous tenses. So first form plus ing, it is present participle. It is non-finite verb. So in short, you can say that past participles are the verb which ended in ed, and present participles are the form of verb which are ending in by adding ing. Now coming to book exercise. Present participle or past participle. Write the verb in parenthesis in the correct form. Present participle. What is present participle? First form plus ing. And past participle. What is past participle? When you add ed with verb or third form of verb. Dash by the best cook in town. The meal was shared poetry. Shared poetry. The meal was very artistically made. Prepared. So we will choose past participle. Prepared by the best cook in town. Prepared by the best cook in town. The meal was shared poetry. So the sentence is in past, so we will use past participle. After dash all day, her head was aching in the evening. After studying, we will use the present participle. After studying all day, her head was aching in the evening. Dash on the sofa, they were watching TV. We will use present participle. Laying on the sofa, they were watching TV. Everybody was dash to hear the news. Everybody was shocked. We will use past participle. Shocked to hear the news. Before dash the house, I always check if all lights are switched off. Before leaving, we will use present participle. Before leaving the house, I always check if all lights are switched off. So we will use present or past participle according to the need of the sentence. Now coming to combine the following pairs of sentences by using participles, present or past. The first one has been done. So we have to combine the two sentences by using present or past participle. We met a boy, full stop, he was carrying a heavy bag. We met a boy carrying a heavy bag. So the house was decorated with lights. It looked beautiful. The house decorated with lights looked beautiful. We have combined these two sentences into one by putting present or past participle in between them. The house decorated with lights looked beautiful. Third one is the robber saw the policeman, full stop, they ran away. Seeing the policeman, the robbers ran away. We use present participle over here. I found the door open, full stop. I went inside. Finding the door open, I went inside. Finding is present participle. The police saw the body. It was floating down the river. The police saw the body floating down the river. So we use present participle over here. Now coming to clauses. The clause. Clauses come in three types: main or independent clause, subordinate or dependent clause, relative or adjective, and noun. Every clause have at least a subject and a verb. What is main clause? First one is main clause or independent clause. Every main clause will follow this pattern: subject plus verb is equal to complete thought. Examples are: lazy students always complain. So students is subject, complaints mean verb. So it completes the pattern. Water spilled over the glass and splashed onto the counter. Water is subject, spilled and splashed are verbs. My cat loves milk, cat subject, loves verb. The important point to remember is that every sentence must have at least one main clause. So what is main clause? Which have subject plus verb or predicate. Now coming to subordinate clause. Subordinate clause or dependent clause. A subordinate clause will follow this pattern: subordinate conjunction, subject plus verb is equal to incomplete thought. What are subordinate conjunction? So the words whenever, as, but, if, these are considered as subordinate conjunction. Whenever lazy student complain, whenever is subordinate conjunction, subject is students and verb is complain. As water spilled over the glass and splashed onto the counter, as is subordinate conjunction, water is subject, spilled and splash are verbs. The important point to remember about subordinate clause is that they never stand alone as complete sentence. To complete the thought, you attach each subordinate clause to a main clause. So why it is named as dependent clause? Because it is dependent on main clause. It complete the sentence, it complete the sense. It cannot complete a sense in itself. It needed main clause to complete its sense. Generally, the punctuation looks like this. We add punctuation in subordinate clause. There are two types of writing subordinate clause. First of all, a sentence may be in this form: main clause plus no comma plus subordinate clause. Main clause is directly followed by subordinate clause. And if subordinate clause in the start of the sentence, so it is followed by punctuation and then main clause is written. So there are two types of writing subordinate clause. First of all, if main clause is leading the sentence, so it will be directly followed by subordinate clause without adding any punctuation. If the sentence will start with subordinate clause, then it will be followed by punctuation or comma, and then we will add main clause. Example: whenever lazy students complain, whenever lazy student complain, comma, Mrs. Ramesh throws chalk at their heads. So whenever lazy students complain, this part of sentence is subordinate clause and it is followed by punctuation, comma, and then we add main clause. So it is one of the writing pattern of subordinate clause. Now coming to relative clause. A relative clause will begin with a relative pronouns. What are the relative pronouns? Such as who, whom, whose, which, or, that, or are relative adverbs: when, where, how, or why. The patterns look like these. Now coming to book exercise. Read the sentence and decide if the bold words form a dependent, independent or relative clause. We have to figure out that the bold writing is dependent, independent or relative clause. Tahir did his homework before he went to bed. We have to figure out whether Tahir did his homework is dependent, independent or relative clause. Tahir did his homework. This part of sentence give us a complete sense, so it is independent clause. Isn't that the woman who lives across the road from you? The woman who lives. So the use of relative pronouns are here who. So we will write that this part of sentence is a relative clause. Because the test was so difficult, none of the students got a very good grade. None of the student got a very good grade. It is the main clause, and this part of sentence is main clause or independent clause. She is very fit because she goes running every day. It is dependent clause. Because she goes running every day, it is dependent clause. Because she goes running every day, it is not giving us complete sense. So it is dependent on the first part of his sentence. So it is considered as dependent clause. The police said the accident that happened last night was unavoidable. So the accident that happened, it is a relative clause because the relative pronoun has been used over here, which is that. That shows that it is relative clause. I don't like Mondays. I don't like Mondays. It is only one clause and it is independent clause. It gives us complete sense. Have you seen those people who we met on holidays? Those who we met. Who we met? So it is relative clause. Can you tell me why you said that? Can you tell me? It give me complete sentence, so it is independent clause. You should not believe everything that you read in the newspaper. Everything that it is relative clause. If you help me, I will help you. If you help me, it is dependent clause. If clause is used over here, it is dependent clause. So it was all about dependent, independent or relative clause. Now coming to activity, revise transitive, intransitive verb and present past participle. Thank you.